In this video, we're going to be talking about the DiRootsOne application, which is actually a bundle of 8 different Autodesk Revit plugins for boosting productivity. Most importantly, it's absolutely free. Let's go. Now, as I said, this is a completely free plugin, so if you want to check it out, I'm going to include a link to it up in the cards above. Now, before we jump into Revit, I just first wanted to learn more about DiRoots and what do they do and what they're all about, and for that, well, their founder and CEO is going to help me with.
We are a software development company, and our expertise extends beyond the custom AutoCAD or Revit plugins, as we also offer desktop and web-based applications development. Our deepening understanding of workflows and process in the AEC industry set us apart from the competition as we help make our clients' dreams a reality. Don't forget that DiRoots is well known for creating amazing free tools like DiRootsOne Pro Sheets, DiRoots App Manager, and DiStellar.
Now, after that, their product manager actually helped me understand the entire plugin and all of the tools that we get. And I actually have a 42-minute call with him. And if you want to check out this entire call and learn more about DiRoots in depth, I'm going to be including that on my Patreon page so all of my patrons can find it. And I'm going to link that up in the cards above and then also down below in the description of this video. By getting access to my Patreon, you will not only see this video, but also you will get access to all of my Revit project files. Okay, so now it's time to see what stood out to me and which are the features that kind of I found most interesting. And for that, let's jump into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and this is the office building, which I'm going to be using as just an example project. So now let's get started by going here to the DiRootsOne tab, which is something that's going to appear once you installed it. And then here you can see on different panels, we have different tools. So let's start with the SheetLink panel. So SheetLink, as the name would imply, allows you to connect elements from Revit to sheets. But this isn't going to be only schedules. You can see you can connect model categories or parameters from model categories, annotation categories, elements, schedules, and even spatial, which is rooms and spaces. So let me explain how this would work. It allows you to set, in this case, I'm going to be taking a certain category and I'm going to be exporting a schedule of certain parameters from that category. Now you might be thinking, why do I need this exported schedule? Well, the idea is I can export it, fill it out with data, and then bring it back into Revit. So for example, we're going to have a situation where I need some information from the door manufacturer for the doors which are in my model. So one way to do it would be to contact manufacturer. They would send me probably some PDFs, and then I would have to input that information manually, wasting my time and also leaving room for error. With the SheetLink tool, what I can do is just export the parameters that need to be filled out. They have a table and they fill it out themselves, making sure that everything is done correctly and making sure that I don't have to do it. And then I can just import that, and all of that data, all of those parameter values are now being fed directly back into the model. So let me demonstrate. What I'm going to do is just select door categories. Here we have a list of parameters, so I'm just going to pick out the ones that I want. So for example, family and type is one of them. And now I have basically placed all of those parameters here. If you don't want certain parameters, so for example, I don't want description anymore, I can just bring it back here, so it's no longer there. And keep in mind, when the parameter is red, that means that it cannot be edited. But for example, comments, those are instance parameters, and we know they can be edited. And this is the parameter that I want the door manufacturer to enter values for. So now what I would do is just go here to export. I'm going to make sure that it's checked, open Excel file after export, and then export to Excel. I'm going to save it on my desktop. and it's going to bring up Excel. And here we have our table, and you can see this is the information that we have. And now I can just come here to the comments and I can enter the value. So I have just written value for all of the comments for this single flush door. And once we have that done, I can just come here and save this document and I can then close it. So now I can go back here and go to import from Excel, and I'm just going to select that same door file, and now the model has been updated successfully. So now if I close this up and then if I come in here and find one of those doors, I think this is one of them, what you'll notice here under comments, now it says value. So it basically fed all of that information into the model. And I think it's really powerful. Okay, this was a simple explanation, but you can imagine the possibilities. Now we're going to be taking a look at TableGen. So if I open this up, this tool allows you to bring in non-BIM data into your model. Now you might be thinking, well, non-BIM data, that's just wrong. And it is, it's terrible, but we still today have certain project requirements where we have to include some non-BIM data to be part of our projects. So you have two options. One would be to have that kind of as a separate file, or more likely series of separate files, or alternatively, you can bring even that inside of Revit so you can at least manage it from there and have it all kind of inside of one project file. So the TableGen allows us to bring this data in quickly and easily. So what I can do here is just go to add tables. We have to specify the file, and I have created this Excel file for the demonstration. Open that up, and then here specify the worksheet and the worksheet region. And then we have the view type. So we can generate this as a legend view, as a schedule view, or as a drafting view. I'm just going to leave it as a legend view and click OK. And then we just need to click apply, and it's going to generate that view. Okay, and then I can just right click here on the view itself, go to open view, and then we can just close out of this. And as you can see here, we have that test table, which I have created, and it looks okay. I can select it, edit text, and so on and so forth. So it's nice to have that non-BIM data still inside of our project, so we can at least pick out on which sheet we want to place it, and so on and so forth. And of course, you can always change the Excel file and then update it later. Okay, now let's move to sheets. So what I'm going to show you here is in the project browser, here I have only created one sheet, this kind of underground level sheet. And here I have my underground floor plan, and I have a schedule of all of the rooms. Now, let's say this is a really tall building and we want to generate basically this sheet configuration for each of the levels. So I want to have a floor plan and I want to have a schedule next to it. Well, with that, we can get some help from SheetGen or sheet generation. So here, what this allows you to do is to use the existing sheet as a template and then just create multiple ones. So let me show you how that would work. I can go here to new sheet. It's going to ask me to select the sheet to be used as template, which is going to be this one over here. Number of sheets, that's going to be 5. Because I have 5 more levels in this case, and then I can just click create, and it's going to create those sheets. Now here, first you have to add the numbers and sheet names, which is something that I'm going to do now. And here we go. So now it turns out that I actually don't need this one, so I'll just delete that one. Okay, so now it's time to populate these. For that, we would have to go here to view a list. And then what I'm going to do here is just pick out a schedule and a floor plan for each of these. So for a schedule, for the ground level, it's the ground level schedule. Here for this floor plan, this is the ground level floor plan. So that's this one. Select. Then we have level 1. So that's, let's see, level 1 schedule. Select. And the level 1 floor plan, select, and so on and so forth. So you're basically just kind of filling this out and just picking out the levels and the sheets that you want to show here, or the floor plans and sheets. This is level 2, second level, select, and then for roof, we don't really have a roof schedule, so I'm just going to add the roof floor plan. So once we have set all of this up, I can just hit apply and it's going to generate all of that here in Revit. So now if I close this up, as you can see, now we have multiple sheets, and each one of those has exactly what we want to show. In this case, we might want to move this down. Overall, I think it's a really good time saver when it comes to generating your sheets. Now, speaking of views on a sheet, let's go to the View Manager, which I really like because it gives you kind of a overhead view of all of the views that you have in your project. So what you can do here, as you can see, we have all of the views that we have available in the project that we have created. Then I can go here to parameters, and now we can pick out which parameters we want. I'm just going to select all of them and bring them in and click OK. So now it's going to show all of that here in this table. Now you can do some batch actions and so on, but in this case, I just want to show you that basically, it just shows you everything that you have here, and then you can make some changes. So you can change perhaps the scale, title on the sheet, or the title, sheet number, and so on and so forth. For example, you can change the view template. So for my level one, I can come here and then I can decide to use architecture plan view template. I can come to one of my 3D views, and then here instead of hidden line, I can go with shaded. And once I apply, those changes will now apply to the model itself. So if I go, for example, to my 3D view, oops, was this the 3D view? Oh no, these are the renderings. Okay, let's go to the 3D view. Yeah, so I think this is now, changed. Or one of these, whichever one I have picked out. Yeah, there we go. So now this is a shaded view. So as you can see, the changes apply from the view manager. So I think overall, it's just powerful to have that overhead view over all of the views that you have. Now, moving forward, let's go to the Family Reviser. So Family Reviser allows you to manage your families. So one of the options that we have is to create these repositories. So here you can select the category. In this case, I've just selected doors. You can go to preferences, and then here you can add or remove repositories. So I'm just going to create one, and let's create a new folder here called doors. So this will be our door family repository. I'm going to select that folder and save it. Now, what this allows us to do is to come here and place all of these doors in that repository, and we can export them. So what this does is it creates a repository of your of different types of families. You can create different ones and just categorize them differently, whatever works best for you. It doesn't have to be by category. So for example, you can have one repository for, let's say, commercial architecture doors, one for residential architecture doors, and so on and so forth. And then you can always come back and import from those repositories in other projects. So it's a good way to kind of store your families and then bring them back into the project when you need. Also, we have the ability to edit the families or edit the names of the families, for example. So here I can find whatever I want. So for example, here elevation, I can type in elevation and go find all. So it's going to find all of the ones with that. And then let's replace it with abbreviation, something like this. And then I can replace all of those. And once I hit apply, it's actually going to replace that in my model. Now, in this case, I don't want that, but what you can do that, you can batch change names and just use rules here in order to easily make some changes. You can add prefixes, suffixes, and so on. And you can even, do you wanna archive it? Yes. And you can even go to worksets and manage those from here. Okay, now I'm just going to exit out of this. And we're going to be concluding this video here. I was just scratching the surface in terms of possibilities, and depending on your needs, I'm sure you can find use for one or all of these tools. So I would encourage you to check it out. As I said, it's absolutely free. And if you want to check out the full demo that we've got from the DiRoots product manager, that's going to be, as I said, on my Patreon page, along with all of my Revit project files, like this office building, for example. So if you want to check that out, I'm just going to link that up down in the description of this video, and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.